I want to talk about the crisis, the response to the crisis, which includes the lockdown and the reopening, and a lot more. Hey guys, it's April 30th, 2020. I'm Original, also known as Dimcad. First, the crisis. Well, Russia just reported having over 100,000 cases. The UK, their Prime Minister Boris Johnson is talking about his plan to reopen their economy, something that everybody's going to have to do at some point. We just can't stay at home forever. It's not practical. This virus isn't going away anytime soon. The question is, what's the correct strategy for that? Well, right here in the U.S., Georgia is reopening. Georgia's reopening. They're taking a lot of slack from a lot of people. They're opening up, I think, salons and much. I mean, yeah, movie theaters, I think, that are scheduled to open them. I don't know about movie theaters. I mean, what are they going to show? I mean, I don't know how the movie industry is going to respond to this. I mean, they've been shut down for the longest. They're going to need good movies at some point because they got to, you know, I'm looking forward to Tenet coming out this year. I'm looking forward to Black Widow coming out later on this year. That new James Bond movie, No Time to Die. But other than that, there's not a lot that I'm looking forward to as far as big budget movies. Anyway, New York is actually handing out free masks, which makes sense. I mean, when you look at the studies, the statistics, essentially half of the U.S. deaths have occurred in New Jersey and New York, half. And you know, I just don't think every single state can respond the same way as New York and New Jersey. Simply because when you look at New York and their situation, people are so densely populated, they live in so close to one another, and so many of them are on the subway. So many of them are using mass transport, they're in close quarters with complete strangers every single day. So their situation is going to be different from other states. So I think states have to assess what's going on there and come up with the best plan to reopen or whatever. I don't think we can expect every state to develop. We can't expect the crisis to develop in every single state the same way it did in New York. You know, obviously, we don't want to lose any Americans, but at this point, we lost, I think, close to 60,000 Americans because of this whole situation. The U.S. intel community, by the way, is now reporting that this virus is not man-made. Not man-made. It's not genetically monitored, manipulated, modified, or anything like that. That's what they're reporting for the U.S. intelligence community. At this point, who can you really trust? The U.S. government, if they were transparent and honest from the very beginning, it would be easier to believe anything that they're saying. But they haven't been. You know, everything from, oh, it's just fake, it's not a big deal, from Donald Trump to, you know, you don't need a mask. You know, but they don't work. The masks don't work, but give them to our healthcare. Let's just give them to our healthcare professionals. Like, what the heck are you saying? Then later on, oh, yeah, okay, maybe everybody should wear a mask. I mean, come on, at this point, who do you really trust? Which is interesting. This whole article, this AP article I came across, was talking about Americans struggling to get good information about this whole crisis. A lot of, you know, you have the media, which is so anti-Trump. It's just absolutely ridiculous. And then, you know, you have Trump himself, who spends half his conferences, his news conferences or whatever, briefings, whatever the heck you want to call them, although he suspended that. I'll talk about that in a second. He spent half of those things basically talking about himself and how good of a job he's doing and blah, blah, this. It's just, they should have been shorter, right? More fact-filled, right to the point, okay? That's what it should have been. And that's why so many people don't really trust what he's saying. I don't listen to him anymore either. You know, and I voted for the guy. At this point, I'm not listening to him. I got to the same point with Obama, too. I mean, although I never voted for him. It doesn't matter who I voted for. The bottom line is, who can you really trust? You can't trust the media. You can't trust these politicians, left or right. They're just, who do you really trust? And that's why there's so many conspiracy theories out there. Because people can't trust what they're getting from the mainstream media. They can't trust what they're getting from politicians. A lot of these people are lacking credibility. For example, the mayor of New York, obviously, the city's supposed to be under lockdown, and he's out like 40 miles. He's far away from his home, out there walking in some park or something, which I don't have anything against, but he needs to be consistent. You know, if you're telling everybody to stay home, you need to do the same damn thing, okay? If you go into the park, hey, that's cool, but don't be telling anybody to keep your ass home. So that sort of hurts his credibility. A mayor of Chicago, she's getting her hair, she actually got a haircut. She took a lot of criticism for that. Because again, you know, her message is to be consistency. You know, you can't say do this and then you do something else. People see that and they see hypocrisy and they just stop listening to you. They just stop listening to you. It's like, oh, what the hell, this person. And you know what? I understand why she wants to get her hair cut. She's got a point. She's in the public eye. She needs to keep her hair looking decent. I agree with that. Just make sure, you know, that's consistent with what you expect from other people. I understand she's a mayor, but at the same time, Mayor of Chicago, you know, make sure you're, what you're doing is in line with what you're telling other people to do, as far as lockdown and all other stuff. Anyway, there's a, I think LA County is the first county, well, there's a LA, Los Angeles, that whole area is the first area where, you know, they're actually gonna have widespread testing. You know, you wanna get tested, you get tested. Here in Pikeville, Kentucky, we had a situation like that for a couple of days, where they had a lot of tests for people who just wanna get tested just to see their status. And they had that going on for a few days, and then they moved on to another part of the state, which, you know, for me, I mean, why would you only do that for several days? Don't you need something like that widespread, not just for a couple of days or so, you know, for weeks maybe, so you have some idea? Who knows at this point? Oh, hypocrisy, yeah, okay. Well, Joe Biden, he's doing really well in the polls, right? He's beating Trump by 6 or 7 points. So some polls have him up as much as 10 points. And Trump apparently went off on his campaign advisor. He freaked out on him. He just is blowing off steam or whatever, which, you know, I understand. But, you know, at the same time, you got to make sure you're doing the best job that you can do before you start blowing off, before you start yelling at your campaign manager or whatever. You know, you got to be, make sure you're a good candidate, a good president, before you start yelling at somebody. Let's see if that actually changes. I mentioned hypocrisy because Joe Biden, he is doing really well, but you wouldn't know that he's doing. You wouldn't know that he's being accused of an assault, something like that, violating a woman's rights. So let's just put it that way, right? He's been accused of that. By Tara Reid, I believe. I forgot her last name. She accused him a long time ago. She said she told her mother or brother or some other people, a friend, neighbor or whatever, and these people are coming out saying, yeah, okay, she did mention this. For me, that's not really proof. For me, if somebody commits a crime like that, you need to go to the police and report that. And I do believe in due process, whether you're a Republican or a Democrat. But Alyssa Milano, well, when Brett Kavanaugh was being accused and he was having his hearings to become a Supreme Court justice, she showed up at the hearing and they were trying to confirm him, but they're also trying to look and see if he was guilty of doing something to this one woman, Miss Ford. She didn't seem all that credible to me. However, you have all these Democrats coming out saying, oh, believe her, believe her. That's what they kept saying, believe her. Yeah, Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the House, she's singing a different tune now that Joe Biden is being accused of something pretty awful. Alyssa Milano, who I had a huge crush on when I was a kid, she was in Who's the Boss, and then later on Charmed, loved those shows, loved her in those shows. But I gotta call her out on this, man. She's been quiet as a mouse about this whole situation. As, you know, as long as there's a Republican being accused, it's like, okay, hashtag, you know what? You know, it's believe her, but then once there's a Democrat, then everybody's really quiet, like, oh, they changed their tune. And it's just, it's not surprising. It's not surprising at all, but it's just something we gotta look at. Due process, everybody should have due process, so should Joe Biden. You know, he's not being accused in court or anything like that. He's not facing any criminal charges. You know, due process, we should look at the information, look at the evidence. But we gotta be consistent with this. Again, consistency. Don't say, oh, well, you know, when it's Brett Kavanaugh, I believe her, we gotta reject him from becoming a member of the Supreme Court. And when it's Joe Biden, it's like, oh, we're, you know, oh, I love you. Hillary Clinton appeared on some video cast or whatever with Joe Biden, and she was talking about how she basically endorsed him, not a big surprise. She has a history of and supporting questionable characters. Okay, I'll just put it that way. All right. Again, innocent until proven guilty. But what do you guys think about this whole situation? Okay, switching gears to the economy. 4.7 negative 4.7. GDP, negative 4.7. Pretty significant. Okay, very significant when you have all these people at home, all these people losing their jobs. Pretty big number there. We're officially in a recession. Nobody's surprised by that at all. The farmers, that whole situation. Why won't they consider the Prime Act? The Prime Act is something where it will allow farmers to directly go ahead and sell things to the consumer. That's not going to happen because the federal government will lose control of that whole system. They want to control the food. You know, they lose that type of power, and that's pretty significant. I just think a lot of these people in D.C., they just want to control. That's just basically it. And there's some other reasons behind it, too. You know, money and other things, jobs and whatever. But they're not going to pass a Prime Act. This is something that I learned while watching the Silver Report Uncut. It's a really good YouTube channel. Somebody mentioned that. If you're into the economic stuff, yes, he's really good. Uneducated Economist, another good YouTube channel to check out as well. If you're into MGTOW, which, you know, I like that stuff, Red Pill Men's Health. I love watching that channel, Red Pill Men's Health. Great content on there. Donovan Sharp, love watching his stuff. Better Bachelor, love watching his stuff as well. Coach Greg Adams, if you're into that stuff. So these are some of the things that I'm into. As far as music, I'm listening to The Weeknd right now. I'm listening to Dua Lipa. Love that album. As if you don't like sort of like the pop disco thing, you won't like that. But I just love it. I just love it. It's just right down the road. I just listen to that all day. But I'm into that type of stuff. That's what I'm listening to right now at this moment. Some R&B as well. But anyway, that's what's going on. These are some of the things that are on my mind right now, economically. This is one last thing I gotta mention about this as far as economy. I'm seeing this in my life as well. Some of these businesses are having a hard time finding people to work because when people were laid off, they had a strong incentive to stay unemployed. Okay, because now the government is promising $600, an additional $600 per month for unemployment. So on top of what you would normally get from the state, an additional $600 per week, I should say, per week. That's pretty substantial. It's a strong incentive to stay at home. Really strong incentive for a lot of people to stay at home. And I've been talking to people. They've been saying, I've been trying to fill positions. And they're saying that numerous people are trying to avoid employment because of this situation. Now keep in mind, it's not supposed to work that way, because if you get a job offer and you're on unemployment, you're supposed to accept it, because if you don't, then you're no longer qualified. That's the way it's supposed to work. So I think a lot of people, they might not even get a phone call or something, you know. Oh, they see it's their old boss. They got laid off like 3 or 4 weeks ago. They see it's their old boss and they're like, oh, no, I'm not going to answer that. Nope, not going to answer it. You know, that may be something that people might do. So LA, first city to offer countywide testing. Zero Hedge, another great source. If you're looking for information on current events, Zero Hedge, blacklistednews.com, really good places. So I just want to share this with you guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And what do you think is going to happen in July when, you know, that unemployment incentive ends? You know, are they going to extend it for another several months? I think Trump probably will, beyond the election. That's what I think. Or he's just trying to get Congress to do that. I imagine that's what he's going to try to do. If he doesn't, you're going to have a bunch of people, whoop, off of that unemployment, or at least getting a lot less unemployment, and things could get ugly here. It could get ugly. So as far as reopening, I think everybody has to wear a mask. Wear a mask. You know, we can't stay locked up forever. But you guys share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.